Hey, I'm Greg.
And I'm Jimmy.
And Honda Racing F1 have asked us to show you exactly how their master engineers achieve energy saving as big as this.
This time, we look at how the F1 teams were able to generate a massive increase in power.
Now, a Formula One power unit is a fair bit more complex than this, but what we want to do today is break it down to its essence and show you what makes an engine like this tick.
Yeah, let's have a look at the awesome Internal Combustion Engine, or ICE, and how it turns fire into useful movement. It's quite useful, that's quite good, isn't it? Yeah.
So Greg, what I've done is open this engine up so we see exactly what's going on inside.
First up, we are going to inject in our fuel.
We're good. And the next thing I'm going to do is ignite it with this electrical spark, just like a spark plug.
Come on.
You ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, we got it. We got a bit of movement.
So what happened there is those expanding gases forced the piston down, giving us a controlled movement. And that, in turn, will eventually drive the rear wheels of a Formula One car, sending it at breakneck speeds around the track.
Now this, of course, this ICE is a straight four cylinder.
But in a Formula One car, it's a V6. So there's six cylinders in a V formation. Makes it a nice balanced engine.
So next up, we will actually look at how a Formula One car gets so speedy. But to do that, we need a little bit more space. And we need our super high-tech, homemade ICE.
You're also gonna need one of those.
Oh yeah, let's go for a ride.
On my bike.
Down. This bottle is going to be our cylinder.
And our fuel is injected into a little hole right in the top. And this, well, this is our version of a spark plug.
I want to see this. Come on, fire it up.
Greg, watch this.
Yes! Love it. Now, the hope is we're going to get an explosion inside, but rather than it pushing down on the piston, it's going to push a force that way, which is going to send the bottle straight up.
Newton's third law, right there.
Hang on, I do the science. I'm out of a job. Make yourself safe.
Fuel in the top.
Thank you, sir. Now, the fuel has to be combined and reacted with oxygen and heat. Those are the three sides of the fire triangle: fuel, oxygen, heat. The oxygen is already inside. That's in the air that was already inside the bottle.
And our heat is provided by our spark.
I think we're set.
Safe place?
Safe place.
Run the wire out.
Yeah, run the wire. Let's get behind this. Come on, I'd like you to be out of here. Okay, so, going for liftoff. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Yes! I'm gonna get it!
So, in a Honda Formula One internal combustion engine, instead of firing my pop bottle 15 meters into the air, that explosive energy is used to drive the engine, which in turn turns the wheels, sending that Formula One car around the track. It's exactly the same as what's going on inside my motorbike.
I got it. I got it. Really interesting. It's actually a little bit warm still because it's got those exhaust gases inside. Which is exactly, of course, what happens inside the cylinder. That's why you have to push them out. Those waste gases are carbon dioxide, water, a few other bits. It needs to get rid of them so it's ready for the next explosion. But here's the next part of the puzzle. How a Formula One engine gets so much power and so much speed. You might think if you double the amount of fuel, you're going to get a lot more power.
Well, that's not quite right. Because if you double the fuel, you're going to need to double the oxygen. You see, a Formula One engine has six cylinders, and that's a finite amount of space. So to get more oxygen in there, you need to force it in there. And to use that in mechanical terms, we use a turbocharger.
Oh yeah, of course, you need to force more air in, because then it forces more oxygen in. That reacts with the fuel, and it gives you more power for every bang, for every stroke.
So if we're doubling the fuel in our rocket, we need to double the air. We need to turbocharge that bad boy.
Oh yes, right, let's do it. Okay, that's what that's for.
One turbocharger right there.
Slightly modified bottle. Okay, that's for you. Safety never takes a day off.
You can see. One.
Double the amount of fuel.
Two.
Okay, that's gonna go. Pop that on.
Okay, Greg, you need to double the amount of air in there using our turbocharger, which in this instance is a bike pump.
It's a bike pump,
yeah. Force it in.
It's about right.
Yeah, we're good.
Okay, let's go, let's do this.
Done.
Ha, turbocharge time.
So Greg, you ready for a fusion of science and engineering come together?
3, 2, 1. Woo-hoo! Whoa!
Whoa!
I got it! Look at this! That was great! That was so much higher than the first one.
Mental.
And that's because I was using that bike pump to force so many more air molecules in, so many more oxygen molecules. They reacted with the extra fuel. This gave us loads more power, exactly as a turbocharger works in a Formula One engine.
And what's totally incredible is in those racing engines, that happens 750 times every second.
Check out our next film where me and this guy are going to be showing you how the Honda Racing F1's engineers actually make that whole process happen by harnessing the power of the engine's exhaust. 750 times a second.
Want a lift?
No, I'm good, I'm going to walk.